As we are once again alive upon the internet. As I double check that everything is working and everything is yeah, there we go. And pop out of chat and have chat ready there as well. As yeah. I'm gonna jump back in. Don't exactly know what my plans are, but we'll figure something out. And hey there, Muddy. As yeah, bright and early, as yes, it's always appreciated. As yeah, likely I will farm a little bit for Yuzina. I was thinking of doing, as yeah, as I said yesterday, of doing a build showcase today. I'm going to move that back a day, at the very least. Mostly because yeah, I think I had some playtime today. It got eaten up by the descent run, which didn't see me actually going very far, but and then yeah. Got caught up in other work stuff, as you guys see, Yuzina on his own. But that's also not a bad idea to move it back a day, as yeah, giving it a little bit more time to play around with some stuff. Because yeah, I'm pretty certain I want to do it on this Red EP, just as a weird build. It's basically between that and the Pestilence build. But I want to keep Pestilence for in the new season. As I feel that's a build that has some potential of doing well video-wise, as interest is always high in exotics, weirdly enough. Even though they're usually not the best choice. An Iron Horse 8. Yeah, well. Relearning a raid is something I will likely not do my first one on a stream if I were to. But also, yeah, likely not for this season. I'll leave that for future seasons. As yeah, first things first, I'm gonna, as yeah, this character did some countdowns. Their SHD exposure is no longer active. And yeah, I made sure to spend my stars already on my alt account, and on this account I do have a
nice to see you.
Sizable chunk saved up. So yeah, that's 15 exotic caches. Likely going to be 16 by the end of this evening's stream, maybe even 17. But yeah, to start off with, I'm gonna put some time a little bit on this build, although not with the directives I currently have on. As I'm gonna take, actually I'm gonna take everything off for now, just to have it a little bit more easy. As I want to put an hour or so on this build, mess about with it, run around and do some activities. And I'll likely actually even keep the Yuzina zone for later. As I'll just go and assault our way. Gonna want a CP, but not a simple one, more something where they spawn all around. But also not too far, with a little bit of cover. So I'm adding in stipulations. As yeah, I'm gonna reset the world. I kind of know where I want to go now. Okay. This character does have a bunch of green CPs. Oh, and hello there, Pomek. Yeah. Running in. Is it? Don't even know what the zone is, but I want to go hit this thing. Mostly because, yeah, there's two sides. Doesn't let me spawn camp them or anything. kind of to get a refeeling for this build. That's basically the thing that it does. Just shields bashes something, or well, not even shield bashes, but just bashes, and then it wasn't available there. As I need to also, yeah, remember to look at the timer of it. But yeah, melees something and then spreads it. And the thing that it melees, yeah, as long as there's some status effect active on the enemy, it does actually decent amounts of damage, because of course it does. And I will take the shield out mostly just to add the damage bonus of it. So I almost died there as I was standing when I really shouldn't be. I'm gonna go upstairs here and... Oh yeah, actually, SHD exposed is on, right? So that will actually alter survivability of this build quite a bit. Which, maybe I should run it without it, but also, yeah, it's fine. I still got a kill there.
Good job.
So something on the minimap on that side, but apparently it's nothing. Apparently they do not exist. Anyway, I'm gonna grab some ammo, grab some loot upstairs. Oh, and hey there, I see. And snakes as well. Yeah, one of the weird things with this CP always is, I haven't of course done it yet, but this door is already opened. It's just the chest isn't available yet, but you can go in here already. As I'll grab this key chest as well and then call them in.
Reinforcements incoming. Detecting additional hostile contact.
50-50 guess. I'm just going to let them come a lot closer, because I don't want to engage them that far, because I also have I don't have shock rounds yet, but I'll have shock rounds in a little bit. And I basically don't want to engage at these kind of distances. I'd rather them come in a little bit closer. Usually if you don't shoot at them, they will do, but they don't want to, apparently. It would be nice if that medic would stop overhealing everything, but... No idea why they aren't pushing me. Usually because mostly as well they are still with a full pack, which usually enemies are a little less hesitant when they have numbers on you. That was also quite the delayed the good thing about it is at least the reinforcements are here. But these guys seem exceptionally timid. Come on. I'll watch your back. Stop delaying the inevitable. Let's do one of those. Charge transfer initiated. Actually, yeah, this thing on CPs is actually annoying. Mostly because, yeah, I can't push into a full wave of, like, mostly elites and stuff. Like, that's not gonna work out for me. And doesn't really have the firepower to just sit back here and be a red build like I'm trying to make it. Why is that guy out of combat? There was hitting decent numbers, but that's mostly SHD exposed, being active. Serious trauma detected. Who do you think you are? Oh,
George Dredger activated.
There did a thing, but a Scorpio could have done the same thing. that's a downside of it. I love it. And you know what? Let's put it in a fast moving mission. What's kind of like a good fast moving mission? Actually, no. Something where, I mean, Lincoln. Lincoln is a fast moving mission. But yeah, I'm also considering the other option that I could as well do. So I'll put a little bit of time on this one, and then I'll swap over actually after this one, likely. I'll swap over to the Hut Hunter that's skill build, headshot, half headshot, half skill damage. Mess about with that one as well, because I haven't ran that one in a little while as well. As both of these are very much kind of like solo builds, they don't really do much in groups. With any group, you might as well just be something a little bit more useful.
Additional hostiles in the memorial compound. They're moving south. There's a gate between you. It looks closed from here.
Agent, you'll need to find a way to open that gate.
Vital signs critical.
I wish it, like, it had a better way of doing something. Actually, I can use that as well. I'm doing more stuff as a ranged kind of thing, but just the shock of the Elmo that it can kind of spread out.
Medical assistance needed.
Well, yeah, this thing with Ouroboros might actually be, I mean, nah, not really. I mean, it would be interesting, especially with special ammo on the enemies as well. It's not gonna do anything, like, it's more of a silly thing. Let's see, where's the next wave?
Agent charge compromised.
Is it in fights like that? It's basically, what is it doing that normal red couldn't do? And that's just to give a little bit more CC, but also, like, here, I can't push into all these guys and melee one of them. I'm just waiting for the Elmo to fill back up and use the Elmo. I can set that fire, but didn't catch anyone. of it surrounded, so I'm just gonna go to where the least enemies are. Kill those least amount of enemies, and then there's a missile launcher somewhere. So
agent charge compromised.
There had to be two of them. Nope. There's that rocket lady, the aforementioned one.
Charge transfer initiated.
Yeah, like that. That Scorpio could have done the same.
Well, I get Henry's people to maintain the perimeter.
Meleeing isn't. It's just hard to melee. I wouldn't call Tidal fast moving. It's more of a sit in cover and fight your way through. So, negotiated dilemma build for group support buff. I mean, negotiated dilemma doesn't really provide any group buffs, really. So, not particularly. Oh, I mean, setting it up to be a. I mean, you can make anything into a support buffer, but. Especially on the negotiator, odds particularly. Because as a build as well, it benefits from being a damage dealer. It's more of a... You're much better off putting the support on a build that's already, like, leaning towards support. Just like as with Stalker or with Stalker with Striker, you could put opportunistic backpack on it or something, and then run a Scorpio or stuff like that. But yeah, you're also giving up a lot of the personal damage at that point. And hello there, Spoon and Doom. Deconstruct. Is the game really don't want me to? This guy has all resources filled back up, likely, yeah. Because, yeah, tomorrow, of course, we get reset again. We get golden bullets, which, and yeah. It's gonna be fun for a day or two, I think. And then I will likely have my fill of it again. It'll be a good warm-up for the Ouroboros, especially as for when that comes into the game. But yeah, likely during the Golden Bullet Week, I'll mostly I'll do some farming in the evenings, but most of my time I'm gonna put towards doing a build showcase, doing the Heartbreaker build showcase, doing the damage video, the DPS video, and setting up for a third account and running the third account. I think the only way I can get myself to grind Golden Bullet a little bit is to actually force myself to start the third account that time, and then use golden bullets as a farming thing. My main account or my alt account, I don't really care enough about grinding to really make use of golden bullets. The shock round spread on this is actually not worthwhile enough. Still the first run, so I should actually let's grab all the loots. But yeah, also this one without the chest doesn't have the spread, which was by choice, because yeah, otherwise also it gives up way too much damage, I feel. Because yeah, you can use the Eclipse chest, your spread becomes a lot more wide. But yeah, this way I have obliterate, which is yeah, decent chunk of my damage. A very far point to cover to cover to. I could also use my special weapon to get some fires going, maybe. But also, that seems like a lot of work.
You think closing the tunnel is smart?
Oh, shark rounds here, so. Use those.
Shit, falling back. Fuck the
Wait, what? How did you get downstairs so quickly?
Charge compromised.
That's some bad shooting on my end. He's immune. Not much I can do against him. Just waiting for that way. But yeah, he didn't jump down, right? He just teleported down? Or was I crazy there? I just didn't spot a heavy jumping now. Neither would surprise me, but yeah, I feel I would have noticed him jumping now.
The campus has taken position inside the memorial.
Guys, heard if they're gonna actually fix the tournament? I don't. They haven't spoken about the tournament really at all, except. Altering its description, and in PTS it was working how it currently is working, which leads me to believe that this guy just having a sit. He's tired out, buff that. Yeah, leads me to think that they're not gonna do anything about it. They're gonna keep it. And yeah, likely they're gonna add in Ouroboros as well as it is.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Today we dealt a great blow.
It's not gonna be a good look on their end.
We confiscated a massive cache of chemical weapons.
One thing I just wanna do for a second, just for a comparison's sake.
Wow. You saved a lot of lives today.
I haven't. Played much today, so I don't really have a reference frame for how much damage he was doing there. I'm just gonna grab a high-end red in a second and just put an Elmo on it and just see what kind of damage and like feels it does. After that, I'm just gonna run into the first room here. Because she has this one, although I'm not gonna run it like this, I'm gonna run it like this. Yeah, let's Although, yeah, likely this is gonna... Oh, she has a Cheska chest, I believe, right? Does she have a Fenris chest? No. That'd be too easy. Oh, she does have a Fenris chest. All right. So I can do this. Wait, how much am I still over then? 1020... Okay, or am I exactly 60? Is this 55? This is 55, so almost 60. Hey, we found the high-end build for Elma.
We need you to secure the memorial.
Man, this is just for me to get a little bit of a reference.
True Sons will be a direct threat to the campus.
And output difference. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna do one more room with this thing. Let's just get a feeling for it.
It looks closed from here.
Agent, you'll need to find a way to open that gate.
Agent, wait. I kept this glove, didn't I? Is it? I need to, of course, grab this just so my chance goes even lower. Yeah, that's the thing, like, that red DP kind of just, I automatically start just playing it as a red build, and then you might as well just be playing a red build.
Charge compromised.
But that's also kind of my failing, maybe not the build's failing per se. There are the damage outputs were only due to the global event. I think I will just briefly swap over to that other character and put some time as well on that headhunter for drone build, just to have a look at it. And hey there, Mambu, as well. Yeah, indeed, he must have indeed spawned downstairs. Yeah, that in progress, especially with that other one, has been active for a while. I think also last time I looked, it was colored as because they have the coloring scheme, and one of them is for will not fix, and I think that one was colored as will not fix. Although that was a while ago, I remember checking that. I'm just gonna briefly park this character. That build is on a different character. Indeed, as Pomic says, there's as well the Stinger rebalance thing was for PvP. And yeah, it was in the patch notes, and believe it was the case as well. Actually, I'm gonna keep directives as R. As yeah, the other option I was thinking about doing, let's have a look through hers as well. what she has available. Because yeah, Umbra is also always an option for a showcase. But yeah, I want to do something a bit more silly. But yeah, this thing might fit that bill very well. As yeah, this is very much a bad build that I kind of enjoy playing. And I'm just going to grab a CP for it. Just to mess about. I'm going to go No Hope Hotel, but I'm going to reset world first because No Hope is captured for her. I'm gonna keep those three directives on. Our Ragers will get a little bit in the way, but that's fine. Yeah, likely we'll have the snitch as well here.
A hostile control point detected.
Yeah, as well, this week there was a gift backpack. I mean, it's still there. Gift backpack on the vendors, which can be made, which could be made crit chance, crit damage one. So I did grab that one, getting that character that was missing a crit chance, crit damage gift, their gift backpack. So. Where's your owner? Oh. There is his owner. Stand still for a second. The elite patrol is annoying. Is it? They're gonna spot me going in if I go on the right side, so I'll just let them come out and hopefully fight them on the outside. Is it? I want to fight them around this corner just so my skills don't aggro everything else already. And yeah, my first shot is very much going to be that thing. That will likely finish them off. I'm gonna recycle both my skills, just so they're off cooldown. It's gonna. Yeah. I am pressing G. Why was didn't want to go in there. Let me see if I miss anything in there. One of the DZ vendors, if you go to the vendor site, it will actually, you can check it from there. Don't remember which one specifically it was, but there's only three of them, so you can also jump around. But yeah, the vendor site will say so as well. And yeah, it's available for, as always with the names, for 152 DZ credits. As it, this build is a weird thing. It only does really one thing, which is try to Nemesis headshot. And it has a turret and a drone to weaken stuff to the point where it can Nemesis headshot. And, well, also, like, its owner needs to actually be able to headshot. once it gets going, it can one-tap, like, elites and stuff, with a nemesis, of course. But I feel this is kind of a... It is a decent enough of a silly mechanic kind of thing. Because, yeah, trying to basically play a sniper, but doing so... and yeah, once you have a few shots in, I usually... What, I don't have a scope on this thing? Because, yeah. This thing is the future perfection sniper rifle, which will, of course, overcharge my skills if I get a kill with it. And then, yeah, once I do have Headhunter, I can actually get a kill with it. Just gonna wait for my drone to be back and then restart this assault. Longboat skills can be quite useful. Uh-oh.
Immediate medical assistance needed.
Heavy is not the greatest thing for me. Try to sneak one in there. Of course, she rolls the second I'm about to take a shot.
Charge compromised.
Oh, yeah, we also have, of course, the global event. Really? That one shot didn't kill his backpack? That's that's annoying. luckily not on target. why don't you shoot at that thing? That thing's dangerous. Shoot that thing. No, not me, that thing. As with all snipers, oh, he's stuck on... Well, not as with all snipers. As with all snipers, heavies suck. But not as with all snipers, I have a turret and a drone.
Control point secured. Well done.
Which can do some damage.
Let's make this personal.
Let's go. Right,
don't know why I don't have a scope on this thing, but I'm gonna put a scope on that thing. My shot there just to get rid of that guy. Ah, this sway of not being in cover is so annoying. Because you have a bit of increased sway, especially in the Nemesis and stuff, when you aren't in cover. And let me just put a scope on this thing real quickly. Actually, you know what? I'll put the 8x scopes on it. So why do I have it decked out for... I don't care about any of these. That's likely why I have crit chance there. But. Should be fighting a faction that maybe doesn't have helmets, but that would be too smart, so... Charge up time on the Nemesis is sometimes a But yeah, once charged up, 26 million is enough to kill any solo.
Move into position.
Incoming hostiles detected.
Charge time on the Nemesis is nice and long. But yeah, I can clear a CP, just can't do it like... I mean, if you're a better sniper than me, then you can do it a little bit more consistently. But I kind of like the mechanic of it, of just having a headhunter that isn't designed just to max out headhunter, but just to have just enough of a headhunter to be able to kill, and then having a turret and drone to assist with that. And I'm unsure why I'm still in combat. Likely something, as yeah, my turret and my drone were going somewhere down the street there as well, so likely something over there is keeping me in combat. Right, I'm gonna grab some ammo, and then let's do the defense here. What is that sniper skin? Oh, and this thing? This came from one of the seasons, I think. It's Prism. Yeah. As I said, it is nice and gaudy, and yeah, it is like the oil effect kind of thing. But yeah, the tactical 308 doesn't get used much, which is the base weapon for that scalpel. So you don't often see them.
Reinforcements.
Do you know anything about sledgehammer affecting Chungus? Well, sledgehammer affects... So it reads a damage to armor. It isn't a damage to armor. First of all, because it's not additive to damage to armor. So it is its own separate multiplier. Secondly, it also affects armor plates, like warhounds and heavies, which, it's just weird. Because, yeah, well, what we've taken to calling it quite often is amplified damage to armor and armor plates, which is a bit longer than the DTA that they say, but that's also more accurate. Which is also important sometimes. But yeah, this thing I kind of like for just as a solo sniper. Because yeah, you kind of get some respite, because you... Usually as a solo sniper, the annoying thing is everything's shooting at you. So that's why like Headhunter kind of becomes the thing to do. Because yeah, you need to like insta-kill stuff so you don't instantly die. But yeah, with this thing, you have a turret and drone taking some of the aggro for you. Letting you, you know, snipe in peace. Although I would love for my skills to not be pushing these guys back. Out of med packs, I just noticed. Yeah. Drone, please go kill that one. Yes, that one, go kill it. Yeah, that's my shot there. Oh. There we go. I forgot that the 8x, of course, doesn't have the same reticule, which which let's grab something that actually has. I saw this guy running behind that guy, and I assumed it was friendly, but it of course isn't.
Won't survive much longer like this.
All right.
Supply room access unlocked.
Kind of leaning more towards this one. It's really cool to see. I am British. Wait, what? Are they out in the streets or something? Was I seeing it through the walls? Okay, I'm seeing it. For a second there, I thought he was inside there with me. As I saw the marker, like, deceptively close. But yeah, especially this build kind of works off of the Nemesis, because it needs that Nemesis to actually, like, get its damage to the point where it can actually kill. but it can kill well enough. I mean, it did a heroic CP there, so. Let's see if there's any more med packs here. There are. Yeah, let's go fight. Actually, you know what? I want to go do this CP. Because yeah, on the assault, I have some places to set up. On the defense, I have the roof to go to. And yeah, the Nemesis itself, just that charge-up mechanic, can be kind of cool, especially if you play long with it. Because the thing is as well, with especially if you're running it with like Headhunter or something, you can charge up fully for your first shot and get like a really decent first shot out. And then once you really get a feel for it, because I know players that like really play the Nemesis a lot, they kind of know of like, okay, for Elite, once my Headhunter is fully charged up, I only need to charge it up like a third of the way. And then for a Red, I can basically insta shoot kind of things. Which you kind of really only get if you just play with it a lot. Some do. Okay, here I'm going to set up here. I didn't get spotted coming in. That was just the other stuff. Okay, once this fight gets going, I will get spotted. But yeah, I kind of like the mechanic here, especially of just having the turret and the drone weaken enemies for me. And, well, keep them busy as well, of course. But yeah. For instance, if I can't headshot, if it's all elites, I can't really headshot the first one anyway. Or, like, there's a heavy there. I'll put my turret and my drone to deal with them, and then I go and deal with other stuff.
Charge compromised.
Oh, yeah, my drone doesn't want to go. Of course she stops just as I keep it on. And yeah, the that was a body shot. And I kind of missed the mantis thing of, you know what? Let's try it with the mantis. Because, yeah, I like the thing of the mantis of here's the heads is actually, I find exceptionally useful in actual use. But sometimes it's actually hard to see that there is a head there. Or that there's a there.
Heavily armored hostile detected.
Surprised that didn't even body shot. What is my first shot? No. I'll know once I hit one. Okay, 3 million. That's not enough to, like, do two shots on a red if I need to charge up. But of course, I have my turret and my drone to everything done for me.
Location guarded by hostiles.
CP captured. Good job.
That wasn't too bad. And then I got to go sit up on the roof. What am I? Oh, there's a bag on the ground. It wouldn't let me deconstruct, but that's usually if you're like too close to a bag or something, it does that. Okay, I gotta... Yeah, it is indeed like weird. Sledgehammer is weird like that. It got added in a weird way. But yeah, basically it's and DTA, but also not DTA because yeah, it's multiplicative to DTA. So it's just a complete separate own multiplier. And on top of that, it does apply to armor plates as well. I'm going to put my turret up on there.
Reinforcements incoming.
Does Nemesis have foam nades?
Incoming hostiles detected.
I don't think I've ever seen them used. Trying to think of if I've even seen them seeing them use grenades, but yeah, usually there is you mostly use skills.
Guarding location nearby.
Keep your fucking...
But yeah, if they do have grenades, most likely they do because yeah, the names and stuff do have. Usually, if they have grenades, it can be basically anything. Nice of that guy to lose his AI. Just stand there and let me headshot him. Sniping, not really my thing. I can do it a little bit. Sometimes I'll even get two shots in a row, but usually, eventually, I start failing. Oh, the rusher died back there. And that worked. While I'm here, might as well grab the loot as well. Seeing as I'm upstairs.
Supply room access unlocked.
And I'm kind of leaning maybe on doing it for this build. It will also save me some time because I don't need to make a damage calculation sheet for this thing. Because yeah, Headhunter builds don't really benefit from that. It's mostly just... better off showing like the one hit, like the first hit and the full hit of the headhunter for each of the weapons, which the thing already has, basically the build picture already has. Kind of want just a small activity that will do. And yeah, I'm gonna do, of course, the thing that yeah. Don't try this at home, kids. Which I totally don't have one of those white deaths with determined. No, of course I don't. But of course I do. Because yeah, it's... of course I do. Let's get a Nemesis as the main weapon, as the sniper, as the exotic. That's the word I was looking for. They murder a deer, which will cost them their lives. Oh, actually, it got away, apparently. Yeah, I'm gonna cover to cover towards here. Gonna need her to turn around. Because, yeah, she's gonna spot me once I cover to cover again. Because I wanna set them on that side just because they're more likely to spawn back there. So I wanna Madam, could you turn around? Could you stop looking my way? I wish I had a coin or something. Hitman style, just pass a coin to our Witcher. You know what? I'll just risk it. Yeah. It was fine. Turns out. We Sam Fisher our way towards here. Let's see, I want to put my turret here because yeah, they're going to spawn over there. Okay. Should actually have taken the shot first before I sent in my turret on my drone. Oh, okay. Much smarter. Before I made them wiggle. Of course, I hit that weak point. My drone is after the wrong thing.
Detecting additional hostile contacts. Hostile control point.
I feel that was on target. That one wasn't.
Access key detected.
It doesn't feel right, but it works annoyingly. Let's go do this downstairs one as well, just to see. Some stream, there's a guy that's saying his nemesis got 3 skills. I mean, if it's on a stream, he will have footage of it, most likely. I don't think I've seen 3 skills out of a nemesis, but that doesn't mean that they can't. What I have seen is them have 2 of the, especially if you give them randoms, having like 2 skills in the way that we can't, of just having like a fire cam and an oxy, which we normally of course wouldn't be able to. But yeah, because usually I do keep kind of track of like what the nemesises have as their skills, just. That's gonna be my death. That's it. That lawnmower came in pretty quick, likely from Elite. But yeah, I'm gonna go and hit another activity. Zdera was a little bit too aggressive. Also, I didn't need to be that close. I actually would want to be even further away than I was. These guys will be a good target. And again, I should have.
Damn this drone!
Yeah. Sir. Did you really have to wiggle as much as you did?
Incoming hostiles detected.
One of those flying fuckers!
Yeah, once I get this going, can I kill an elite? Is basically the question. Likely not. He's hitting with 12 million there. There's a sign in my way. It has barely enough. As I run 9 million-ish is what usually elites have around this around this scaling. You know what? Let's go kill these. One skill from his teammate to the left before Nemesis found. One skill from his teammate. That would be interesting, yeah. That I could totally see that happening. I don't think I've ever had a Nemesis run where someone left before the Nemesis. Wouldn't have ran into that yet. This land.
All of you that were treated like animals on Roosevelt Island. I swear, the outcasts will burn every last one of those responsible.
Yeah. Turret's in position to. Surprising that that guy didn't ignite on my turret. So we'll have one more wave, seeing as the key did not drop there. Yeah, this thing might actually be better for all those people running determined hotshots over running them with hotshot of just running them this way. Because yeah, it has enough damage to kill elites. Although yeah, you need a red to set it up, so it's not as clear cut. Actually, yeah, so its backpack talent is tech support, which... Is that thing free talentable, I wonder? It is free talentable, because, yeah. that would be a place where I would mess about with it, I feel. Because, yeah, of course, Vigilance could give it a little bit more firepower, but I think I lined it up decently well for what it's having... some damage on itself. Like having enough damage on itself to like... Because yeah, I used to especially run this with the Nemesis and then have the scalpel there once it's fully charged up to just overcharge the turret and the drone. Because yeah, the turret and drone do some killing as well. Because they're in this setup there. Every piece has skill damage. Three pieces are Empress as well, so it's getting... six skill damage rolls, six tiers as well, of course, with Technician. And then, having skill damage and skill efficiency with three pieces of Empress. And then, yeah, the other two pieces are in service actually, I should swap these two with Habsburg, shouldn't I? Because, or am I just misremembering? So yeah, before I say something stupid, I'm gonna go out of left before. okay. Brand set. Red, not blue, of course, because it's Habsburg. Because Habsburg is 15% marksman, right? It is indeed 15% marksman. Where RLD is, of course, 10%. Wait, are they also worded differently? No, okay. RLD is just misworded on the gear spreadsheet as MMR damage. But yeah, it's marksman rifle damage, as it states there. So yeah, I should actually do that, maybe, especially if I want to do a build showcase on it. Which might give me as well the goal of what I want to do for part of the rest of the evening. Because I'm kind of feeling this one as the build showcase. It's a quirky enough build that has enough utility to be worthwhile and kind of works. Works well enough for it to be an actual choice that you can go for. So there's no way to reorder loadouts, right? No. I mean, so the only thing you can do is delete one and then like all of the slots move up one. But that's of course not always useful. That's never really useful. But yeah, what I usually do is just name them and then just like when I'm moving slots around is usually as well, I will have emptied one out usually. And then I just like copy paste and then just move them around. But yeah, it's not great. And yeah, mostly because we started out with only 6 loadout slots a long, long time ago. so they didn't back then likely imagine that, those kinds of things would be needed. But yeah, they are. I think I've made my decision, which is going to be that this is going to be the quirky build showcase that will run tomorrow. But yeah, I am going to give it an upgrade because it deserves it, which is going to involve getting 2 Habsburg pieces to Recore. They will come with blue cores anyway, so... Because I do have the option here as well of recoring it. Because I went out of my way most likely to have that option. But I remember as well running this with Sharpshooter for a while. Just to try it out. But yeah, of course, with the turret and drone, just technician makes too much sense. But yeah, I'm going to go farm some Habsburg. And I feel I saw Habsburg being on the map in New York. So I'm going to hop on over there. And yeah, those kind of things, like some more quality of life things like those would be nice to be able to move slots around and stuff. But yeah, they've neglected quality of life on quite a lot of things lately, I feel. Yeah, I'm gonna grab our Striker Tech Tank. Put an Elmo on it. Swap its backpack, which is how all my tech tanks are now set up. If I want to take them with the Elmo, I just swap it. Habsburg is on this zone, which is decently farmable because, yeah, there's also elite territory control there and some CPs. And yeah, if anybody's interested in some Habsburg pieces, I'll do some Habsburg and then likely move on over to the Usina zone. Because yeah, I don't feel these 2 pieces will be hard to get, and they're likely as well both craftable, because yeah, Habsburg is one of the newer brands, meaning that they are often very craftable. And yeah, both parts are. But yeah, I want to go farming for something, as I haven't done so in a while. So, and yeah, for those interested in running some, I feel I still have 3 directives on. I should have some, I think, right? Running some 3 directive open world stuff. Feel free to, if you have me on the list, just join on me and. If I don't have you on my list yet, feel free to ask and we can accommodate that. As Salty jumps in. As I said, this Elite Territory Control is a good one to start off with. Oh, although I see I have them. Yeah, let me just fix that. I have the AR bug, which is annoying. I'm gonna log out and then I'll join back up on you in a second. They're salty, okay? This will disband the group annoyingly, but I'll join back up on you, being closer to that. As yeah, that ammo bug is super annoying. Grab some apple, pear, and red fruit smoothie. And I'll join back up on Salty there. Is it jumped down for a second there? That's quite the bitter aftertaste, but
another agent.
Let's say it's healthy, even though it's mostly sugar. So as I, we have a bunch of friends. That's two patrols moving together as one. Pomex joins as well. As yeah, my ammo issue has been fixed. So we got to actually double checking as well that this gal also has all her resources filled up, which she does. Ready for tomorrow to remind about it would be better to change weapon type damage on specializations. Weapon type. Oh, you mean the selection you make? That
would be.
Well, I mean, what they should do is you just put. So instead of just the ones that like making a selection, it should just be that it's towards all weapon types. Like that choice is just. Because you're never gonna run more than three weapon types anyway, and there is no like. Benefit of like if you have more of this weapon type or more of this type as I was expecting my shield to keep up a little bit more, but of course we have the global event but that makes bullets hurt quite a lot. It's just the named heavy left. Although, yeah, if he puts his minigun in the wall, I can't shoot the chain off, which, you know.
Access key detected.
Oh, that's a courier. Oh. Where's this last one? Oh, that's not a Black Tusk. But yeah, I was saying something and I lost my train of thought. It should just be that you just put like however much you put in now for three weapon types, and you basically get all weapon types worth of damage out of it. That would be just a much better setup for it. This is also the daily today or something. It is. So we'll complete that one as well. So yeah, it's just resupplying a CP as well in a second. Well, it's going into specific categories, like, still kind of matters, but it should just be 40 or like the same 15% into just the all, like, all different types of it. Oh, yeah, actually, if you put it into every category, yeah, at that point, doesn't matter anymore as well. So yeah, it could just be all weapon damage. It's 15% all weapon damage for the same specialization cost, basically. But yeah, I still as well have sometimes that I have builds that are set up on specific characters, as we're moving towards the CP here. And then I'll go like, oh, wait, but this character now has like four different weapon types on Technician. As I was checking for the named enemy here, which isn't here currently. So, as yeah, let's go capture this CP as well. Oh yeah, and if you guys get so what am I after? So headshot, skill damage, glove, and holster that can be recorded. Yeah, if you guys run into any of those, feel free to make me happy. It's a much easier grind than the other ones we've been on lately.
Targeting the hostile.
Charge exposed.
The cover here. Get some spread going. That's likely a named group. It is with Wolfie.
Also, control point nearby.
No, indeed, exactly. Yeah, Xena. Is it out of a game, like game design thing? I kind of understand it because, yeah, making people make choices like that is. You know, it's an easy thing to add in into those kinds of trees. Just like letting people kind of like out of a game making sense, kind of like, okay, I'll make this build for these kinds of things. I'll make this build. But yeah, in reality, it just doesn't line up well. just makes it an annoying thing you kind of have to deal with, or just move around. Yes, especially firewall, of course, going onto SMGs, shotguns. You also usually want to have it, for instance, with Hunter's Fury Headhunter, so you want pistols as well. Meaning that, yeah, if you have an AR build that uses firewall, then like it becomes annoying at that point. So you don't want to have that character be, you know, having shotguns or having SMG, stuff like that. Because it's basically just exactly. Yeah, it would be a good quality of life. And the annoying thing with it is as well, like, I would also love for it to be able to. So the good thing, what they should do as well is actually do the same thing to the. To the choice in Technician. Because technically, with how much I run tech tanks and stuff. Oh, yeah, sorry, guys. I just ran in here and assaulted. I didn't even actually pay attention if everybody was ready or not. I was talking. Oh yeah, the Technician choice. Yeah, because yeah, with how much I run tech tanks, I should actually put it to to repair. But of course, I always keep it to damage because I can live with 10% or less repair. But.
Heavily armored,
or have them go into the saves of loadouts. Although yeah, that would also require some work of just. You know, that could also be annoying, and it would be some place where like it's easy for them to mess up basically and make it so that nobody understands what's going on. Because yeah, if you don't know what's going on and you save something and then you load it and then, but yeah, you, most people would understand after a while. It's another thing of just like that could go wrong. Yeah, if everybody's ready, let's call them in. But yeah, I would love for them to just do a quality of pass. I think everybody's ready.
Reinforcements en route. Detecting additional hostile contacts.
On the far left. I'm gonna go get in their faces. Spawned here again. I don't know why Deconstruct today feels so laggy. Just doesn't want to do it. I'm too far out of optimal. Let's get a little closer. Oh yeah, by the time I reach that point, although hopefully they'll spawn here. They didn't. Back the other way! You know what, I'll go kill this straggler. I feel my allies have the rest. I'll have the back of this shield guy, so... guys, because otherwise they'll keep me in combat. So I got a courier there as well. So yeah, the Habsburg names are drop a lot. They drop a lot, which I would love to see on Usina, but. But yeah, that would be just for selfish reasons. They should just fix the drop rate. That's the actual answer. Hey, one thing we could do actually is daily for today is basically what we did now and pathway. So we could maybe do pathway as that's not a horrible, although actually what is the target on pathway? It's Brazos. Basically that would be the full daily project for today. But yeah, make sure to, as well, the CP officer actually still has plenty of space to donate to. So I donated my 50. So we're going to cherish it as well. What was that one? Just gloves and knees, gloves and holster. I mean, I kind of need them to be gloves and holster because, yeah, otherwise I need to, like, go farm replacement parts. But yeah, gloves and holster should be not too hard to get, I feel. Worst case, I can craft them as well, but, you know, might as well farm a little. Weapon handling, headshot damage. Yeah, indeed, you can craft it, especially if you're also willing to buy the resources from, like, just the vendors, whenever it's on a vendor. Let's maybe head up, because, yeah, we have a nice line of, like, four items heading into the other CP. So let's maybe just hit all four along the way if you guys are up for it. Because, yeah, that's... because, yeah, we're going to go from the other... from the safe house to the CP, but we could also just go hit all this stuff. Get some levels along the way as well. Some stuff behind us. So I'm gonna go help over there first.
The government is trying to tell you that they have a right to enforce their laws here. That's false. They have no rights here.
Let's start this thing and then. Another way of seeing us. This guy dropped no key.
Charge compromised. Progress halted.
You know, the Elmo shock being annoying and actually hunching that enemy over outside of my line of sight. They were like, if I had the FAMAS in my hands, they would just be, you know, open target basically. Actually, what I'll do, because yeah, for CPs and stuff, this chest striker kind of works, but actually for all this open world stuff, I'd much rather be obliterate chested striker tech tank, which I changed to now. Because yeah, nowadays I do keep the pieces for it, because this one is a better all-rounder, kind of, but it's... it's also just a worse heartbreaker, I feel. As yeah, let's head down the street and hit all of the other things.
Civilians in distress.
An elite shield guy versus an elite heavy. I don't feel that is a fair fight they set up there.
Charge compromised.
So, waiting for my allies to catch up. And then I will engage them before they actually execute, although it wasn't like gonna happen anytime really soon there, but sometimes they suddenly execute, which is annoying. As I said, there's a voice line that is supposed to play. Especially I feel that the New York factions quite often, like, just the hostage suddenly dies. That voice line ever playing.
Incoming hostiles detected. Hostile broadcast detected.
I got this! Which basically is always the same thing of just the... Like, they're coming from the south, from where we came. Where's the last one? There's the last one. Yeah, especially if you have watch alls. It can be much faster to do it that way. Although, of course, I have enough resources and stuff as well to go for that. Although, yeah, Habsburg not being shared amongst your characters. Although, likely on each character, I have like 150 saved up of it. Although, of course, I also have plenty of, like, this character as well as like 1.4 million credits. So I could buy a ton as well. But yeah, also having something to farm once in a while is its own fun. Because yeah, I'm actually likely to get these items instead of the... Can I interact with this without... Okay, no, the aggro on interaction. Okay. Which I feel I knew already. You can kind of sneak up on them, especially if they have their back turned to you, as long as you're also not running. I aggroed some other stuff down there as well.
Charge compromised. Princess Key detected. Don't forget that we run this down. We've got enough resources to last a lifetime.
Got some cleaners. Of food to get back what I donated. Also, I should, we can double back for that bounty. Let's keep heading northbound and let's hit that other CP. As in there as well, is that the odd place that does not open when it should.
We'll help if we can.
And New York is pretty good for resources as well. As actually, this is a food area, so I can actually just grab some of this food and fill back up to what I donated to that project. I don't think like anybody cares. is the actual answer to it. So many people just run one character and like will never even notice that it is broken. But I feel I noticed it like when Brazos came out, and then I totally forgot about it till I like recently. I needed a Habsburg piece for something on my alt accounts. Oh yeah, it was for the bro style third drone hybrid. And that's like when I like got reminded of it. Oh yeah, none of these share correctly. Because most likely as well, it's just a pointer that is incorrect, that like nobody remembered how to like point stuff like that together to to work correctly. And yeah, let's head into this CP as well and we'll finish up this zone. And also, I've got on a few gloves. Let me actually see that I don't have the one I'm after yet. Which I don't. Sneaking in.
This guard duty crap reminds me of when I was a jarhead.
And let's maybe call our allies in when combat starts, just so they don't interfere with the defense waves. I kind of like Pomic's idea. Okay, I'm gonna stick around here and go and fight these guys. Actually, what I'll do is I'll call them in a second. Sorry as well. I'm gonna call them in now. He's up. I'm setting up to farm the spawn, and I'm gonna kind of do the same. But I'm gonna first stack up on these guys and then double back over. Cleaning up the outside. Trying to do a cover to cover because yeah, they have a full charge, so that will help. But yeah, likely as well that we'll just keep transferring around and help us kill all of these. I feel I didn't see a name for a second there, but maybe because my allies got them. Because we are actually on defense, right? Yeah. Go in here, grab that. Flanked me on my right, I know that, but grabbing mementos is usually actually safer than just running away. A little bit of bonus armor will usually be enough to survive with. I'll take a second here, clear up that armor break, there's no need. Keep that. I don't know. Coming down the middle. I'm gonna do this as well. Oh. Lost my charge just before.
Don't you know what you did? She's
exposed to melee. Detected. Location guarded. I have armed hostiles.
There again was one of those Elmo moments of shocking something into cover. As much as it's handy for its crit chance, crit damage, it's... I mean, the shock is more useful, more often than it's not useful, but... This is exactly what I was hoping to avoid with calling our allies in as early as we did. Which is that they quite often will spread around enemies way too much. I don't think they have any more on them. It doesn't look like it. And actually, yeah, there's an elite territory control that spawned in. We just did that other one. And yeah, they're coming... I'm gonna assume these are from the... CP and not from the territory control. Although yeah, if we push in any further in here, we will actually aggro the territory control most likely. Although actually yeah, that voice line likely means that these are from the CP or from the territory control. But yeah, let's play the voice line of additional contacts, which yeah. Isn't the yeah, the boss has already spawned, so gonna push into these guys.
Agent charge compromised.
I'm hoping Pomek has it over there, which, yeah, so we captured the CP, he likely does. That's it, I got sidetracked.
Access key detected.
On the... should be in range, hopefully. They got a courier from the CP and a cherished from the territory control there. Completions.
Friendly control point detected.
Yeah, let's double back and go get our loots. And hey there, Wienerville. And I'm doing well, as you ask how my day has been so far. It was pretty uneventful. I got to do I wasted quite a lot of time in the sun today. Although, in a fun way, I enjoyed my time in there. But yeah, I didn't get super far. As I got a run going that went decently well, so I was like, let's see how far we can push this. How far was around, I think, loop 28 or 29 before I... yeah, basically, that's with crit damage. Before I accidentally died to some rogues. But yeah, I got basically just destroyed by like a bomber drone and a seeker and the sniper turret. Like, they had like an oxy as well. Like, I think they had like the dream team of horrible skills. But yeah, that ate up a lot of my time today, so didn't do much else. But I have some time tomorrow as well, so... Tomorrow I'll likely put out a new video on something. I have a few subjects in mind. I haven't, like, completely just winging it, but somewhat, mostly winging it. And yeah, let's maybe go hit this public execution as well. And then, if you guys are up for it, let's maybe do pathway, finishing up the daily. And then maybe we'll move it on over to the Usina zone, if you guys are interested in some Usinas as well. Or maybe something else, if you guys are interested in something else. Basically, also, if nothing else, we'll just gaining a few last SHD exposed levels. A few more stars. This is a weird place for a chest, I feel. Feels so exposed. So, is there a resource in here? Ah, there is. Is it? When there's a chute, there quite often is some resources underneath it, especially in New York. In DC, there's a lot of those chutes that...
Rogue agent detected.
They're gonna be here, I'm gonna guess?
Civilians in danger.
Looks like it.
Rogue restore hive detected.
Anyway, the reason I knew that is that, they usually spawn on resource nodes in the open world, so...
Rogue stinger hive detected.
Let's see.
Hostile stinger hive detected.
And seeing as that was the nearest one.
Rogue defender drone detected.
See one over there. Oh, they have, one of them has oxy. We'll have four of them in total. I'm gonna use this guy to stack on. Yeah, if nothing else, these guys will give us... where did that toss go? Okay. One is behind us, but I kind of need to finish off this guy. Double back and up over here-ish. I only count three loot piles so far, so one is still active. It's kind of confused there because there was a named over there, so that could have also been the last one. But yeah, I couldn't see the last one. Let's go into the forum sometime. Hold on, very nice. Yeah, indeed, minor stuff like that, a lot of people, if you don't run into it, if you have only one character, you're never gonna run into that. Could this be useful for something? Well, hang on to it for a second, but not really. But that was a weapon handling head career with weapon handling headshot. I'm thinking of Sacrum's fire will trigger it because it doesn't matter that it's coming from a talent. It's just the status effect at the end of the day. But yeah, and yeah, indeed, they had like the perfect, like, that was, because yeah, I evaded the rolly, and then I got hit by the bomber drone, and then tried to avoid the sniper turret, and then got hit by the oxy, I had already lost my token a little bit earlier to Outcast Rusher, and like the rogues were also like in the room where the supply like the store would be.
Charge exposed.
But yeah, I didn't feel bad about it because also I didn't mean to go as far as I did, and also I hadn't eaten at that point, so basically it ended and I was like, okay, I get to go eat now. I get to go do groceries and eat and then like have a normal stream without me just being there and being half dead because I haven't eaten at all or something. But I also got a reconstructed cache out of it. Although, of course, those are going to be a lot more easy to get next thingy. But yeah, it was on my alt account. And so they also now have...
civilians in distress.
Man, I keep getting worse with names, especially of named. They're Grupo Perfect Spark Chest. Which I also have on my main account, oddly enough. Doorkeeper's Knock. That's the name I was looking for there. But yeah, a lot of the... courier with Hasbro and thingies. I might take that if you don't have any use for it. Oh, I see. Get a bounty out of here as well. Oh, thank you. Oh, that was pretty high up there as well, so... But yeah, I'm gonna hang on to that one because yeah, I do wanna make a hazard protected Eclipse eventually. It's low priority for me. It's also likely as well the slot I've saved up for it I'm gonna use up for Ortiz. Let's head to Pathway. We basically made the run all the way up to here, but we can just fast travel now. Because also, yeah, indeed, that's the shared not working since Usina. I think it has been every brand, right? Like, since Usina. As my character is floating in the air a little bit, which is a little bit weird. Those feet are not touching the ground. And that's also why it's doing the crowd walk. that is quite the way to stand. That looks funny. But yeah, I had never noticed that over here before. Might also just be when there's like water under there. Although yeah, actually what I'll do as well here, if you guys are staying at those two right, I'm gonna swap over to being Eclipse because of course I am. And yeah, we'll just keep it three directives as we are now. And yeah, I don't know if anybody's wanting to join us for this, so feel free to do so if you have them on the list. And otherwise, I'll start matchmaking like a room in. We can fill up to a fort, we can just carry whoever. So let me deconstruct those other backpacks I had. Yeah, let's head it on in, and then nobody takes the offer. I'll start some matchmaking. Oh, sorry guys. Gonna give us a loading screen as I forgot to set the actual mission, which is also like I was like, wait, where's the voice line? But. Wait, when does the voice line play? When we reach here, right? Or something? No voice line?
We should have burned them already. A deal is a deal.
But there was a Kelso voice line there. But maybe it didn't play because I reset the mission there. I don't know.
Coward exposed.
Feels good to be back on Eclipse. I actually haven't eclipsed much, mostly because yeah, I've been messing about with like the ongoing directive tech tank, the future initiative tech tank, some of the other builds. I'm doing a bunch of open world stuff where... Yeah, Eclipse, I usually prefer going tech tank over Eclipse for myself. Maybe it's Eclipses do always feel like home to me. It's, Oh, that was surprising that that bounced weird. Take a slight detour and go up here, where we'll grab one key chest. This one I feel as well that a lot of people go past, even though it's nice and easy. But yeah, we can jump down here as well, which is usually where I jump down. Oh, did I miss that shield guy? That's what all that's happened there. I was so sure of my shot that I just started moving up already.
Charge compromised.
So I'm gonna do this as well.
Charge transfer activated.
That's it.
Kajika's still running.
That way I'm not spreading only fire, I'm also spreading exposure. Catbird seat down here. As I pay those guys in exposure.
Find out where he's heading.
This gear is not good to me. Yeah, the gear itself. I mean, the gear set is. The brand is completely. Not something that has any interest, really, I think. Obviously, as well. But the gear set is decent, I feel. The LMG will be useful, I feel, for ongoing. And yeah, the Ouroboros, if it goes in as is, will become the new meta. Guaranteed, basically. Yeah, and the chest doesn't do anything really either. And I'm gonna enjoy all of the people linking me to video. Well, enjoy all of the people linking me to creators making builds with a perfect unstoppable force, which isn't gonna be useful. I'm surprised though. Oh, actually, well, we just had rogues, so we're on cooldown stuff. I was gonna say I'm surprised we didn't get rogues there, but yeah. We just got rogues, so. As I missed two shots, and I should actually just, set something on fire and not, like, be surprised that I missed two shots, because I miss two shots quite often. Go on some ad duty.
Kajika's on the run again. Finish off those cleaners and stay after them. Keep the heat on him, Agent. He'll run out of rogues soon enough.
Actually, let me do this. Might as well carry a person person to some completion.
Isaac's picking up a lot of vibrations.
Careful, that filled up quickly. It is the daily project, so. Well, it is part of the daily project, and all of that. people join pretty quickly. And yeah, here we're gonna shoot this yellow chest on the ceiling there of the this thing and gain one more weapon. Crate.
Drive that thing right through here.
Shit. I knew they were planning something big, but I didn't expect this.
That guy has a lot of armor. PFE, okay. Wait, they were... I want to have a look at that in a second as well, but yeah, there's a good moment in a little bit when we are waiting for the door. And,
this tunnel is falling apart.
Because I feel they had a Gila mask, which was a chill out, but then they didn't have a Fox's Prayer, which is the thing you use when you have a chill out.
Find a way to destroy that drill. We can't let the cleaners reach Haven.
Fuel stockpile detected.
We need to get this drill out of operation. Rhodes, any ideas?
Giant. Here's to see if that's on target. Exactly. I am impressed with myself. Although yeah, actually, I just from the orange, I could see that it was the stairs. Because yeah, I could see that it was this. And then yeah, I went to the top of the stairs basically to place the cam there. But yeah, I am even impressed by myself there, getting that one on target from half of a room away. Just watch out because you guys do need, well, Pomek needs to be in the gather zone, so yeah, don't push out too far. Because yeah, otherwise you do get a loading screen and miss half of the fight. Although actually, yeah, someone needs to start it as well. Oh, I'll go. So I was going for the shock rounds there as well. So I do want to still go get them, so I will. I'll put my hive here as well. Here I'm gonna shoot that cam because I wanna ignite that cam later. Which is actually a thing that it came up as somebody was watching my masterclass of Eclipse. Two were watching it kinda together, so and it came up that like, because I do it as well sometimes, is putting down two cams that I want to ignite at different times. And what I'll do then is shoot one. Meaning that there are times when, yeah, shooting a cam is actually a choice. Although, of course, it's such a outlier thing. Like, only really happens in times like that, where like, I put a cam here, I put a cam there, and then, like, shoot one and... I'll hang on to that when I share it, maybe. It's not a worthwhile piece, but it's not bad. We have a moment here, which yeah, I'm gonna use to, oh, okay, it's not a... Oh, it's...
Is that a commission?
It is a chilla. Oh, it's with crit chance, bro. okay.
Good job taking out that drill.
Oh, it's because he wants to use this. Okay.
Salvaging the stuff.
He needs that crit chance for that.
Already lost too many people. If they breach,
because he wants to use the doctor's
left to save.
Now get back to Kajika. Isaac's detecting movement in the tunnels up ahead.
Taking out that drill.
Which is a weird choice. Yeah, Monarch's doing the speedrun strat of fast traveling. If Kajika, but yeah, doing that of course misses out on this one resource. So that's why I do the slow run. Well, Actually, the reason is because I will always forget to do stuff like that. Unless, like, actually speedrunning. And yeah, here what I'll do is actually quickly grab a blinder firefly for the next two fights.
Just keep on going.
Guess the cleaners have more control over the city than we thought.
Had, Kelso. With that drill out of action, we made a serious dent in their operation.
I hope you're right.
The only thing we need to worry about right now is finding Kajika.
Can't see the last guy. Oh.
Agent down.
Couldn't get it out in time to save Fauna. Although, why are you on that side of them? Oh, did you try to run past them? Okay. Can you even do that on Heroic? I don't feel you can even really do that on Heroic. But that's usually what you can do kind of on the leak runs and stuff. It's just... Yeah, I'm gonna go down there as well.
Agent out of action.
That guy was a lot less exposed than I thought he was. Should have just sent the chem. That's actually what I should have done. And get myself in cover. But yeah, luckily there I didn't actually ignite right away, or nobody was shooting as well, which of course severely hamper my existence as some would call it. It would be a significant emotional event if that chem were to suddenly ignite with me in it. Swap back to my hive as let my allies open that door. Or wait. Yeah. Okay. I mean, does that usually work on Heroic? I think like two heavies are kind of hard to run past. Oh yeah, with different building.
Incoming hostile communication.
Yeah, there's always some enemies just running past those pillars, so I just do it like that. One in front, one behind. I'm gonna put my hive there as well. Parts of the next wave will likely run into him.
Hostile shock trap detected.
That was surprising that that did not catch them. I'm gonna deconstruct my hive here because I want some charges back up on it. What I'll do here is shock him in place. Mostly just keeping him in place for my allies.
Agent. Steam detected. Visuals compromised.
Yes.
Get away from that steam and finish him off.
The Ubisoft Connect, of course, once again detects steam installed on my PC and decreases the visual fidelity of the game. As I'm waiting for somebody to jump into my fire, and then I'm gonna jump down here. And what I'll do as well is get shocked and then toss my hive up there. Although, landed outside, which is super annoying because I don't think it will work from there. Uh, No, I needed to land inside. Usually, yeah, I toss it through the window, basically. Oh, well, it's hitting the enemies I was hoping for it to hit, which is what I... That's it. There's a heavy jumping down.
Transfer initiated.
Break his chest, or well, something. I think I broke his helmet. And then get back to working on Kajika.
You picked the wrong side, Agent.
Steam detected. Visuals compromised.
He's trying to trap you. Get away from that steam and finish him off. Lure him down there. Beat him at his own game.
It's gonna jump into that. Usually I try to catch the other guys with it as well, but did a little bit too early. Especially with most of the team up here, it's
looks like I'm gonna have to finish you off myself.
The entire team up here.
Rogue agent deceased.
Because if you commit everyone to be up here, then it goes like this.
Damn thing.
He will die very quickly.
He must have been holed up in here for a while. Find where he was hiding and search for clues.
A split up team and search for clues.
Kajika's targets. He really knew how to cover his tracks.
One left. I guess this is why
we also grabbed the key, meaning that we do get
you made a big difference.
One extra chest of loot.
Well done.
Yeah, we do finish the mission. Which also includes the daily. It's one thing I noticed, actually, I hadn't noticed that ever before, but just because I usually don't use the legend in New York, but in New York, the legend actually doesn't work in the same way that it does in DC, where it like shows all of the activities in one map, which is weird. I don't know why. We do have elite territory control over there. Let's maybe go say hi to them, and then if you guys are up for it, we'll move on over to the Usina zone and do some more over there. No, that's the other way. Turned around there. And yeah, no problems, Salty. Take a minute if you need to. We'll travel over there and then wait for you to get back. First, they drop some loot. So that's run all the way over here.
We're clear.
Yeah, sure. I'm curious to see what our... Oh, we did in 18 minutes, which is pretty good. Yeah, Bomek took it on damage. As the camera leaves us. I'll fix it in a second. Oh, I don't know why I went and grabbed... Oh yeah, actually, I know why I went. I went to grab these flame rounds. Grab this. But yeah, I went for the memento there as well, although of course I'm no longer running my memento. So take a second here to fix the camera. And we'll give Salty a second before we start the engagement. Well, actually, what we could do is actually engage this already and just wait with popping the chests till he's back. Actually, I think. Oh, he's on. He's already back. You don't know where they spawn here. Okay, from there. That's good to know.
Charge exposed.
I'm gonna be an exhibitionist and expose myself even further.
Charge transfer activated. Detecting additional hostile contacts. Immediate medical assistance needed.
Let's go. With that as well, blind them as well. Let's re-expose them. So they're having a little bit of a breakdown.
Access key detected.
Yep. Chester up there.
Detected from the control point in proximity.
And yeah, let's maybe cross on over and go and deal with a little bit of the Usina zone. If at least I'm guessing you guys need some Usina pieces, hopefully as well. That's worthwhile to all of us. And kind of considering what I want to run with this character. Because I could actually stay Eclipse for the assault here. Yeah, which I will, I think. Because, yeah, there's a... The assault end can be done decently well with an Eclipse. The defense, not so much on that. On the Christmas one. Hit this territory control along the way. Checking where Salty is. That likely they may still need a minute as well. We started attacking. there. So let's engage this because yeah, there's an elite convoy heading out of the CP nearby. I picked a horrible target there, which was an elite for my fire. By the looks of it, from where we came. Although they got engaged with something else as well, next line. Or maybe those aren't our ones. Although, yeah, likely they are. No, well, it starts decent. With a closer, but not the closer. I'm taking some pop shots. I'm staying Eclipse here, which I don't usually do on the open world.
Hostiles guarding location nearby.
But you're here for the assault on this coming CP. It can actually be pretty strong. And then usually what I do is I'm keeping my hive here because I want to use it on that CP. But yeah, usually what I do is just grab a blinder firefly as a replacement for the hive, because the hive usually needs you to like get it into position. And that's not always viable. Where a blinder firefly just goes. We're not going to catch up to that thing, I feel. We could do it together with the other CP, but by the time we reach it, it will be at that CP. As I would say, let's maybe just go hit the CP that is near to us. What I want to attempt to do here is sneak around the back. Although, yeah, I see some Black Desk already fighting over here. So that's likely not going to happen, but might still. Whoa, wait, what? Oh, that mini tank blinded him. Okay, yeah, they're already getting scattered, so I'm going to start engaging. So yeah, what I wanted to do is push into here and like catch them as they're spawning, which I still might be able to, mostly because I also have a ton of special ammo. Play ammo. I'm gonna give up and respawn in. I needed to make it upstairs and I went actually the wrong way, but that mini tank was there as well. That mini tank also kept me from like moving around on the outside. So I hope nobody went in after me, because that's not a survivable place. Okay. Oh, Pomek went outside. Which is a much more survivable place. Is it what I should have done is this up here and then double back for it. I can get in here, I can like do stuff like this.
Incoming hostiles detected. Heavily armored hostile detected.
Gonna do instinct fire there. Gonna do cover to cover.
Agent out of action.
And I was hoping that for the third shot this Orion, but it's also the last enemy, so it's not a big loss to try. Spomic is getting some you know, he's going like, hey, you have to pay me to, wait, what happened?
An agent needs assistance.
Huh? Come here often? Was that just for, was that being bugged or? I'm gonna guess that was for a reset of a fragile armor, maybe. Or maybe that was showing some solidarity for me going. that's not the right stats for us. Oh, that was weird. As Pong says that he couldn't revive me and couldn't cover to cover. Hopefully that fixed that. Wait, just cover to covering doesn't work? Is that would be a... Cover to cover up here. Wait, does it work like other places or is it just not working? Because yeah, those don't look like cover to covers in the I mean, down here, yeah, at least for me, it does work. That is weird. Not one I've seen before, at least I feel. Anyway, what I'll do, actually, I'll stay Eclipse here. I'll grab a Blinded Firefly. And let's do a defense. Everybody's ready. Oh, actually, did we get the resource convoy? I don't think we got the resource convoy. There we go. As we actually got the completion there. And yeah, if everybody's ready, I'm gonna call them in.
Reinforcements en route. Detecting additional hostile contacts.
They're coming from the other side. Oh, from the far away side. That was weird. I feel I got that one, but again, disagreed with me. Oh. I think Pomek was standing next to the special ammo thing there, and it exploded and cooked off and took him down. Quite rapidly. Because I basically saw one shot going towards him and then he died.
Charge exposed.
Likely they spawn from the other side, but yeah. Go grab the loot first here, guys. We might not come back here. Although unlikely. I should just close it instead of trying to do these long range shots. Although that one should work. Same side.
Charge compromised. Serious trauma detected.
Which charges compromising as easily as they do. On their side. Yeah, this is the downside of this CP, I always feel. It's fighting one side, then the other, then the other. I should catch something. Might even actually be able to do this.
Unlocked.
I don't know if you guys got the chest up here, but I'll go pop it as well.
Immediate medical assistance needed.
Keep this area secure.
Donate a few resources there, because yeah, we have resources lying right here, so might as well.
An agent has disconnected.
I'm gonna guess crashed there by by his sentence there in chat. As annoyingly, the game still for some is a little bit. Wow, that is. What even is there? Territory control, right? That's weird. I feel they fixed maybe a bunch of... Oh, actually, no. It's going to be a hostage rescue. That's why likely this character doesn't have it. Is it? Question marks are exceptionally rare on any of my characters, because I do run them a lot. If you guys are up for it, let's go see what this question mark is, and then we'll fast travel over and get the... Is it? We can go from Haven. Oh, fast travel the way. Do you need me to come back to the CP, or can you show me it anywhere?
Hey, let's see what I've got.
Okay. Well, I'll go see what this question mark is, because I'm afraid it will despawn, and then we can fast travel. I mean, that CP is friendly, so we can fast travel to it at any time. Yeah, I'm curious, because yeah, this has to be a hostage rescue, because
Detective.
I can't imagine anything else. Like, if it's a red thing, it would be exceedingly rare for especially a character, like one of my first three characters to not have it marked on their map. It is a territory control. Interesting. Anyway, this is this place. This is this place. Because, yeah, I've seen territory controls here definitely before. Let's see while Pomic is loading back up. Let's clear this out. We have something to do. Oh, that was laggy. That was poorly. That second one was poorly. Loaded back in pretty quickly.
Incoming hostiles detected.
I spawned from behind there.
Vital signs critical.
I always remember this area as well. I don't think they ever fixed this, right? I'll find out in a second. That's me. Clear this out. Bouncing it off the back there. Comic actually loading.
Hostiles guarding location.
Okay, load back there. See, I think this is this place where we can do this. Nah. I think they might have fixed it at some point. Or was it by the ladder? Nah. Oh, I think this ladder was not here. So what you could do here is continuously jump down and would put you back up here every time. which was like just a weird bugginess. Because yeah, you would try to jump down here and you would end up back up there. But I think this ladder was just not here. Which kind of explained things as well. So there was supposed to be a ladder there, but there wasn't. Messing up the animations. As Pong says there, they can cover to cover again, which, yeah, good thing that, yeah, usually logging out and in fixes that. This pile is also impressive. I don't feel I've seen a pile like that often. but yeah, let's move it on. Unless Pamugisa wanted to show me something there or... Because yeah, let's otherwise move on to the next CP by just going from the from that side. I went to loot, but then to it, my guys started to run the other way. And then, okay, that's yeah, that sometimes happens, but that's usually like lag that causes it. So you basically desync, and then your character basically takes a life of its own because yeah, you're technically like the server thinks you're doing something else than you actually are.
Agent charge compromised.
Here I'll stay Eclipse for the assault, but I'll swap to something else for defense because the defense here is not very eclipsable. Okay, I'll open up with a blinder.
Oh, that's gonna be left.
Some shock rounds over here as well, which I obviously do want. Got you. Send the Eclipse or NSYNC fire out there.
Heavily armored hostile detected.
I'll toss them a grenade.
That was a lucky bounce.
Control point secured. Well done.
Now I'm gonna swap off of this thing. That's why I like eclipses. They're not really the thing for open areas like this. I'll actually go BTSU, red FI. So it's looking for the words there. Give my group some bonuses and I'll get some healing going and we'll get a supercharge eventually. As well. Call them in. I feel everybody's ready.
Reinforcements incoming. Detecting additional hostile contacts.
Those guys aren't our CP defense wave, but they were there, so they get to die as well. That's it. That is our defense wave. Also, this needs to be a Elmo. That's because I need the crit chance. I'd much rather shoot that Mark 16 as a thing to shoot, but not as a thing to Oh, there we are. As it, but this one's always where are they coming from? And then yeah, here they're coming from there. You know what I'll do here as well is I'll supercharge actually. Bombing pulse is there as well and gives us a nice damage boost. But yeah, mostly because I could. This thing, when it's at full health, giving a safeguard as well. It is actually a decent healer. But yeah, of course, like when stuff starts going wrong, I'm also one of the people in the line of fire and getting shot. So I do lose it, but yeah, if I use it a little bit as a second line one. I'm gonna go get the loot back here first. Okay, we are up here. That's what I'd say. I feel there's likely even more loot up there. Which there is.
Hostile broadcast detected.
No good stuffs. Yeah, what I feel we could do is maybe go hit this public execution. Actually, maybe let's hit everything along the way to that public execution. And just farm this zone a little bit. And the public execution is going to put the bounty a little bit north. Oh, so shock rounds back here, which I'll grab. And yeah, I'll stick to this red EP. Red. FI. And run this for a little bit.
This is Dragoff. this to last a lifetime. I look after my family. If you're prepared to fight, come to Wall Street. We'll get you sorted.
I'm using the mechanical animal just to give me a few future perfects.
The government is trying to tell you that they have a right to enforce their laws here.
I went into a spot that has like horrible visibility, so I'm sitting in the middle of a few floodlights. They're coming from behind as well, which is the actual propaganda wave. Off.
Detected. Nearby location guarded by hostiles.
I'm staying back here just to interact with this thing. It's all the Empire cabinet. And worst case, I can send some heals over there anyway. That one's complete. Is it? There's another territory control along the way as well.
Attention. This area is protected by the peacekeepers. If you look in the start zone,
which we can get to by going upstairs here. Oh, this character does not have this phone. That is well.
Yes, figures.
This isn't a very common route, but yeah.
Your guys made the same miscalculation.
Only my main character has all of the phones. That's the one I went around. Well, my main,
no, not really.
Character one.
But I needed to get your attention.
You've got it now.
But
I'm gonna keep it for the next couple of months.
I haven't done it on all characters. Wait for one of my allies to engage whenever they're ready.
Incentives like.
Sniper goes first, although I didn't actually finish him off. Is it here? I believe they spawn back there. That's the only spawn as well. That's definitely a phone that I do know of. I've gotten that quite often, especially on Wony runs where I go through here.
Hostiles guarding location nearby.
Salty didn't have it either, which makes me feel better about it. But yeah, it's only really that character that has all of them. And the rest of them have most. But yeah. Once in a while. Because that also, I didn't think, I didn't pay attention, but also it didn't complete the subset, meaning that there is still one more phone at the very least in that subset. So I still have to, go and get them. I will eventually kind of, I feel, do that on, especially my alt account. I feel I should go and...
Device detected.
Really? She also doesn't have that phone upstairs? Really? I can go look afterwards. Because yeah, there's a phone upstairs by cars, broken cars. But actually, it could also even be that it's not that my character doesn't have it, but one of the characters... One of our characters basically doesn't have it. Oh, we need to engage because they're about to execute. We're doing the sentences where... Basically, that Riker says that, and then the hostage says, please don't, and then they die. And here they'll spawn usually at the end of the pier. And there's one left back here. Just gonna blow that up just to hurt them.
Detecting additional hostile contacts.
End of the pier indeed. That was not the right person. Grab the bounty first, and then we'll go grab the loot back there. And afterwards, I'm gonna run up that, run up there and see if I actually don't have that phone on this character. Is it back here? There's also a key chest, which we can grab. Up on the roof. Yeah, actually, if somebody's full up on keys, I have 37, which is plenty still, but if somebody's full up, might as well spend those. As it, just briefly to check, I'm just gonna get up on this bridge. I remember there being a rope somewhere, but I don't remember exactly where the rope is. So that's yeah, usually where there is a rope, there's a little bit of an overhang. Up there. Oh. Was that just somebody pointing the way, or? No, yeah, this character did not have this phone as well. Weird. Why have I just never really farmed a zone with her? That's weird.
I think they killed those JTS.
Which,
guys.
As well, not a subset complete. So.
A few of them weren't even carrying weapons.
Why would they shoot JTS?
Yeah, seeing as we have that bounty nearby as well, and we are here anyway, let's
get some rest.
Let's maybe go and get that one.
I told you I'd get you to safety. I'm a man of my word.
Salty didn't have that one either. But yeah, it's actually surprising to me that this character, likely I just haven't farmed this zone ever really with them. But yeah, I feel I run under that bridge quite often, going that exact same route kind of thing. Can we jump there? No, it's... But yeah, we have a route down here. Oh, there was a jump as well? Yeah. Oh yeah, indeed, and actually, those floodlights, sometimes usually you can't completely shoot at those specific models of floodlights. But yeah, a lot of the lights you can actually shoot at. It's actually quite useful, especially in Capitol, where you have the Senate room, which is designed to like be you know, hard to see in. What you can actually do is throw up one EMP grenade and it will kind of destroy most of the lights. But yeah, that place as well is actually let me just make sure. Is it there's a chest up there. Which could still be a closer. But it wasn't. But could have been. So you never know, so might as well go and check. Yeah, indeed, it is a nice touch. I kind of as well always like the lighting, and like one of the things that like really like caught me off guard really early in the game, but I always still like remember it just because it was such a like memorable moment is you have that one. It's really early in the campaign. Well, I mean, it's a side mission, so you don't have to do it right away. But one of the earliest SHD caches is in that hotel. It's in the southwest of downtown East. It's a common bounty area as well. It's like that. Oh, most people will know which one I'm talking about. But in there's like the fight in the upstairs lobby before you go down the or before you after you come back up. No, before you go down the elevator. Yeah, that's the normal way of entering. And there is like one lamp hanging there, providing the light for that room. And you can actually shoot out that light and it will go pretty dark in there. And that was like one of the really memorable moments that I will always remember. Of just, I accidentally shot out that light because it's like hanging in your line of fire. They've placed it to be something because you're shooting from one balcony to the other, and it's kind of set up for it to, it's not set up that you're always gonna do it. It's not super in your way or anything, but it is kind of like maybe someone will shoot it if I place it like this. Anyway, you shoot that thing out and it goes like pretty dark in there. And that was like a very like memorable moment for me of like, holy shit, the lighting in this game is actually I mean, the lighting itself, not very much, but just the how they deal with it, with lighting and just some stuff being able to go like really dark. As of course, as well, that one room in District Union is very much, for me, I discovered that one way later, but very much also memorable in that way. And here, you just watch out, so they'll spawn. Yeah, that's their spawn. And yeah, I'm keeping my allies healed up to full because then they'll get their bonuses from me. Even like small chip damage, I'm healing. Yeah, and it was very much as well like that it was, as you said, there's a grain fight organically. And it happened like super, like just by accident. I was just shooting across and like the lamp is hanging kind of at like height level or head level. So, don't we get the, no, it's your, like the player that is at full armor gets the bonus. The FI player doesn't have to be. at full. That's kind of why the healing part of FI is kind of important as well. But otherwise, it would be easy. I would just go hide in a corner and give you guys the bonus all the time. Actually, let's walk out of this zone and see if we can get the bounty to re-trigger. Oh, that is not an uncommon thing to think as, catches a lot of people out. But yeah, it is dependent on the person. So basically, you have to keep your armor at full to receive the FI buff. And every person that loses their full armor will lose their FI buff at that time. It's dependent on the player that is being buffed's armor. But yeah, a lot of people do read it the other way around, that the FI player has to be at full armor, but yeah, that's not how it actually works. But yeah, let's run to like here. I feel at this point we would be outside of the bounty boundary. So everybody's here. Is there? See if I have one of mine still, so I'll pop mine. See if we can cheese it to be here.
Target is near you, agent.
Turns out, yeah, we can. As yeah, this is as well one of those places and one of those zones where it really likes putting it here, so it quite often does. I'm just gonna engage this guy because yeah, he's gonna be annoying us. They come up behind us.
Serious trauma detected.
So reading there, but yeah, basically as well now for you, Pomek, it should show that you have the buff on your buff bar, but I'm not at full arm, so that's like kind of how you can test out. I'll save from healing for a second. These guys are from the supply drop and they're aggroing onto us because we're close enough. So when I got the armor down, I put it to the max as the logo for the buff. Okay, while you were running a fire, you mean? Yeah, because yeah, it's applying to yourself, but with the same mechanics of just when the FI player has the buff. Or has full armor, it's receiving its own buff. So yeah, I can lose the buff without losing it for everyone. But yeah, otherwise as well, the gameplay would be quite different for the FI player of just hanging all the way in the back, never getting any chip damage, because then you would, you know. But yeah, what you had there, Salty, as yeah, you are... while I am healing you, you are still getting armor breaks and... and getting, you know, those add up over time. Just because you're in the healing does not mean that you're super safe. At least not when fragile armor is.
Charge exposed.
Let me do a cover here. Gotcha. Lost my thing before. But yeah, I very much remember as well one long-winded discussion around the time FI came out about that exact same thing of someone being added. Well, in that case, they were also very adamant that it worked that way, and trying to convince them that it didn't work that way was surprisingly took way too long because, yeah, because... we showed it in like seconds of just like, you know, the FI person being at full armor and just, you know, having another person with me and then them losing their armor and the buff leaving them. But yeah, they wouldn't take no for an answer basically until like a lot of people, what was that? Oh no, no! I don't think as bad as he is on some stuff. He has shown that he knows how to test stuff, so something like that would not likely happen. But this was like ages ago. I was just on the official Discord. But yeah, I remember the discussion quite quite vividly still as we dogpiled on the person, and was very much, I think, one of the moments of one person has actually that. Well, they don't play the game anymore, I think, although as well they got eventually banned from from the official Discord. But that was EPH. Well, I mean, just app, I don't know if it's how you spell it. As yeah, they were very much one of the people as well that kind of helped me get kind of situated with the... Like, they were my person that I was asking a bunch of questions to, as they had a pretty good understanding of the game, and they helped me actually quite a lot with understanding parts of the game. Although, yeah, especially at, like, answering questions of, like, how, like, specific talents work and stuff, because, yeah, they had a really good level of knowledge about those kind of things. But, yeah, they were also quite argumentative, and I also remember, like, kind of that discussion being one of the moments of me and him kind of getting along eventually. And it was the beginning of a beautiful frenemyship. Although, well, we weren't ever frenemies, but we liked debating stuff, as yeah. I was very much back then into, even more so into a more balanced approach, as I had gotten off of my glass phase, as I had a glass phase before that. Let's maybe go and grab a few more bounties over there, and then come back and do them over here. If you guys are up for it. So we're going to go get this one, which is through Wall Street. Although this one is always in such a weird position, I feel. And getting there is also through a weird, weird way. So we'll... Oh, crit handling closer. Yes, yeah, that's a double red closer, but not of the right variety. But yeah, I was very much into... I mean, I still am, in a more, like, balanced approach. I'm... Like, I understand the value of... I mean, back then, Striker wasn't what it is now, so... Glass Rats was the thing back then. I always find this place so weird. I feel this is like a place where you would put a secret or something. Because yeah, it's just like an alleyway inside of a building. Like, buildings do have this, which is quite weird, but it's like just a back way in a building. Let's grab these. Might as well. Might get a named out of them. And yeah. We take, like, this inside route, and then it's, like, in this place, which is kind of like a cul-de-sac kind of place where there isn't anything else around here.
Civilians in distress.
As I toss my hive into a mass grave. I'm gonna toss a grenade to open it. And also the spawn of this one is weird, because normally with public execution they spawn pretty far away, but here they'll spawn in that upper and like in that door in a second, because that's the only spawn they have that is nearby here. So yeah, a lot of stuff about this place is kind of weird. And this is also the position, like, whenever you have that issue with being in Wall Street and enemies keeping you in combat, this is that position. God, you came along. But yeah, I do also kind of like the wall painting there.
None of them left.
Isn't it time those guys gave up?
civilians in danger.
I make sure to grab the bounties as well over there. Because as well around here, there's all these places. Yeah, also this one is the weird one, right? I think. Because yeah, there's this like area over this wall. Like there's just places. This used to be open and you could jump down here as well. Because yeah, as you can see, and then yeah, you could like be down there and not have a way back up. And yeah, they fixed this. Because also it's weird because all of this stuff is usually roof, like elements that are normally on a roof. Because yeah, it's like air codes and stuff. But yeah, it's like underground, but then yeah, also. Like that. But yeah, you could jump down here and they basically just placed this wall here. As I remember that being one of the out of bounds places. But yeah, and also like this place is like weird with all of these like dead ends. Because all of these are pretty much dead ends that you can't like get out of. There's like only that one way that we came in. Is it? There's even like more special ammo up here and stuff. But this always felt to me a place where you would put the secret, but also there's a lot of places like that. So they likely been built it as something like that and then like didn't. So we have anything else on here that we could go hit along the way, which doesn't seem like it. So let's maybe go hit the bounties that we have currently and and then we'll see. Because I also as well to this evening don't want to make it too late, but I do still have a little bit of give in me of going a little bit further. No, Mandy, we moved on over to some Yuzinaing. That, of course, is also very much in one of those brands. But the Habsburg, even if I don't get it, I can craft it. But at least now as well. Actually, you know what? Let's get all of this stuff as well while we can.
Target near you.
Let's see, here we can press this button, and this will lower all of the area around here. But yeah, the Habsburg is craftable as well. So, because yeah, I just need a glove and a holster, which is very much a craftable pieces. As Pong says that, to be honest, he thinks he never was in that place. But yeah, it's very, very much just that. There's also only that public execution kind of spawns there, so there's not much to do in that area. So
this time last year, I'd be prepping.
But yeah, just as somebody who likes exploring, I ran into that area. Back in the day when, yeah, that hole did exist, so we could actually jump down as well. That was the cool thing about that area that I quite often went to show, and then they suddenly put a wall there and didn't let us jump down anymore. But so you could jump down there, and then if you walked like where there wasn't ground anymore, you would just fall through the map, and you would be out of bounds. You would be underneath the map, and you could kind of look up, and you would see, like, the what you normally see in, because yeah, the textures are basically on this side and not on the other side. So when you're looking, when you're looking from the other side through, you only see like the textures that are facing you, and you're looking through textures that you're like looking at the wrong side of. Which looks nice and funky. But yeah, it was fun to like walk around underneath the New York map, although a lot of the spots would be out of, so if you basically went underneath the streets, so where you were supposed to be like on top of it, it would count as out of bounds and you would get reset after 3 seconds. But you could avoid basically walking in places where there was anything above you. And then you could stay down there for quite a while and get pretty far and get even underneath the water and stuff. But yeah, I feel at this point, most of the ways of getting underneath the New York or DC map have been fixed. I don't know any of them anymore. Although, I mean, likely there are still some, but I used to know a bunch of them. Well, a bunch of, like, 5, 6. Although most of them were also, like, documented. They would pop up in like, Reddit threads and stuff, so it wasn't like I discovered them all or anything. I did run into a few, like, concurrently with others. And then we went, like, comparing notes of, like, okay, where did you go through the map? And then we would, like, some would be shared. As yeah, Bomi says there, his way of getting underneath the map is sometimes when his potato PC doesn't load everything in, he just falls through. So that's also a way. As yeah, I don't think I've had a PC that was that level of bad, so I don't think I've ran into that specific way. Of course, Coney as well had a few famous ones. Actually, we can push up a little bit closer before we engage. Actually, what I should do as well, just once in a while.
Charge compromise.
Supercharge! So, totally forget that that's a thing that I can do, of course. Making some invincible shields. I'll just watch out for that when the next wave spawns. Gonna blind fire here for a while. Cleared it out decently well. But yeah, I should be using that supercharge more often, but I, as often happens, especially yeah, because I'm moving between builds as well quite often. So. you forget what build you're running and what its purpose is. Well, yeah, I've done some healing, so. Let's see if we can cheese it once more, as we should have more bounties as we'll run across the street and then. But of course, with this one, it is not as profitable as with the cheese position that we did with that character that didn't have any of the side missions, because yeah, that location is very much like super fast. Here, there's a lot of running just from the bounty itself. So we have some people over here, which we might as well kill because they will annoy us otherwise. Yeah, I think if we're across the street here, then that was my bounty, I think. So if somebody else still has some, is it I'm gonna use the mine.
Target is near you, agent.
Oh, yeah. You know what I'll do? I'll run Eclipse here because yeah, Eclipse actually can be good here. From the second room onwards, not this first room. Is it? They have pretty designated spawns, which Eclipse is like. Actually, even in this first room, because I'm gonna go get set up, see if they do spawn there. Is it, if we do get an extra wave here, they'll spawn there. But there wasn't. Loop back there. I'll catch it. Head on in. Is it here as well? Well, they do have actually multiple spawns. They usually, yeah, they set up here and then they spawn only from that door that is next to them. And that is that. I can hide them. I'm actually gonna use most of my med packs here just to clear all that up. And then yeah, here they have the same thing of the first wave is a little bit spread out, but the rest of it is going to only spawn from that one door. So I'm gonna go get very much set up for it. Yeah, it's nice to be playing with competent people where the thing I set on fire got spread quite fast. Which, especially, of course, in, especially weekend matchmaking teams is not a guarantee, not at all. Also, I don't need this in-sync shotgun because I'm not going to refire anything. Much more useful is this this thing, which is the sledgehammer. Surprising she made it that. I don't know if anybody else still has one here, if you guys could check and let me know. Because we should have one more unless we had an overlapping one. Is there nothing else has spawned in on this zone yet? Oh, okay. Well, no. Too even yet. Yeah, let's do the same thing of going in a big fat circle and exiting this area again and restarting it. And yeah, we'll likely do those two. And that will likely be it for me. Well, yeah, actually talking about out of bounds areas, although that one isn't actually an out of bounds area. The getting up to the point of the midpoint of the bridge, which is something that somebody brought up recently, and I was reminded of it because I haven't been there in like quite a while, so I'll likely go over there. Well, you guys want to join me? And we'll go have a look. Oh, actually, was it you? As I haven't been there in quite a while, and I remember as well that being a part of a discussion of somebody saying that it was like an out of bounds area, because it came up with that of like somebody thinking. But yeah, the thing of it is that it's very obviously not, because there's like scenery set there, and there is like, as I was setting up to just in case we had a second wave. But yeah, there's like chests set up there, the scenery set up there. So there's very much like, yeah, it's very much like designed for people to go there. Because yeah, as we know, with out of bounds areas, you have stuff like I showed a second ago, where you're like looking through geometry, or like in the one where with DCD, where you're also kind of like looking through geometry. Oh, yeah, that's loot as well, indeed, with those chests. Yeah, basically where there's loot, it's very unlikely for it to be by accident. Or, well, like an out-of-bounds area. Oh. My grenade bounced very weird, and then it didn't exist? What? Feel I threw a grenade. I feel it in my soul. But yeah, the game very much disagrees with me. Okay. I'll set up for the furrow, same thing. I'm just going over here. I'm gonna set this guy on fire. And help it spread. I'm gonna sledgehammer him as well. Why wouldn't I?
You like light shows?
I love light shows.
You like that?
No, that was it. We're already done. Can't stand in my own fire for a little bit. As a non-glass eclipse. Glass eclipse can't. Yeah, we have one more, so let's go do our diligence and kill them all. As we are from Buenos Aires, and we say kill them all. I'll grab a little bit of sugar, some candy. Give me a little bit of extra energy. And yeah, feel free to up whoever has one left.
Target is near you, agent.
Is that? No, that's in the other zone. Yeah. Really, nothing is spawning in the zone. Well, I didn't pick good targets there.
Charge compromised.
And that's also like even a bug that has existed forever, where it keeps dropping grenades for you that aren't part of your class, especially if you swapped quite often with your class in recent time. But yeah, I should be only basically getting fire grenades, because that's the only, or fire grenades and concussion grenades, which are the two that I can like actively use. But yeah, there, for instance, I was getting EMP grenades, which is a build that I have ran recently, but not this build that I currently have on. I'm gonna use her to start it off with. Or I just waited for the fire to run its course and then the fresh one. Get a named, and it is a setup. It's a crit damage hazard protection one. I don't know if anybody wants one of those. I'll pick it up for now and share it maybe in a bit. Because that one can become crit chance, crit damage with a blue core, which also has uses, but not as many as a full red one, I feel. And I'm gonna set her on fire. That should hopefully spread all the way. Let's get a sledgehammer going. Didn't want to count him as being inside of the sledgehammer area there. You know what, let's get this going as well. Why not? That is a weird occurrence. So exotics usually go on top of the stack. Green stuff as well goes on top of the stack of a stack like this. It has been quite a while that I've seen an exotic not be at the top. But what has happened is, so a loot dropped, and then just in like the same kind of like second, another piece of loot dropped and went on top of this stack. But usually it reorients the stack as well. So we did get another Camleon, better known as exotic component. And yeah, I think we no longer have any more bounties, right? If I kept counts, but I used all mine as well. Of this sound. Which is also, I think, a good time for me to basically end it, because I should get some good rest. But before we go, actually, I think as we did talk about that area, I don't exactly remember how you get there. I kind of remember how you get there, but it's been for like forever. Because I kind of maybe want to use it actually as the intro for tomorrow. So I'm going to go to that control point and just run over there. I remember, it's I remember it being fidgety. I remember it being like annoying to get on that spot. There's like a raised dirt where you can walk. But yeah, it's a place I think I haven't been in like 2 years, because I usually don't go there. Yes. It's there's not much to see there. But yeah, I think it would be a good intro or outro spot of, for something.
I'm not backing down.
Easy. I'm going to kill that. I think it's on that side. That's like the path leading up to it, but is it just this? Is it this? I remember it being like this, right? And then it was like fidgety how you landed over it. Or is it there? Where was it? I remember just slamming my head into this until it lets you go. No, oh, there. Oh yeah. There we go. This is one of those bats that this is as well kind of cool looking of going underneath this bridge. And then coming up here. Is it some chest up here? And there's also like this one, like dead guy set up here. I remember. Is it people were claiming that this was out of bounds? But yeah, oh yeah, this is what I kind of remember. This guy like with his like box of like several games and stuff, which is just, you know, some scenery setting. But yeah, that kind of stuff doesn't get put there like by accident. And then yeah, this is the cables and stuff. So also one thing I feel that a lot of people don't actually notice is that like these cables being cut and stuff is actually the stranded tanker. So the tanker that is all the way up there, like those cables hanging off of it at the part, like because yeah, there's the anchor and stuff hanging on it, but also like those cables are actually like these cables of the bridge that are like snagged onto it. But yeah, this is like what the stranded tanker did, coming like through here, hitting this bridge, and then going all the way through. Oh yeah. Actually, yeah, indeed, there's like some of these game boxes are, yeah, as a World in Conflict, which is another Ubisoft game. Although Death Row, I don't feel Death Row was a... Was Death Row a Ubisoft thing? Because I remember, is this the... Yeah, because, I mean, you have Death Row Records, but I remember this being, yeah, because I remember actually playing this game, which was like a combat game. Like a sports combat game kind of thing. I'm trying to see if I see a publisher on it. Oh, it was Ubisoft, yeah. With the old Ubisoft logo as let me bring that up take the game away, just that box. I remember owning that box. But yeah, it was a Ubisoft one. It's small, but it's in the corner. The old Ubisoft logo. Which, a long time ago. When did this game come out? Because yeah, it was an original Xbox game. No. Retro Records coming up, of course. Retro game. 2002. Board game of the year 2002, as it says in the in-game. In-game board game there as well. Bring it up here. Yeah. Yeah. And then there's a Far Cry box underneath it.
Looks like you earned yourself another bounty. Well done.
Right, so Manny catches up and goes, this is the same pile, I feel. And actually, this is... So here's Death Rose on the top. And yeah, Far Cry 3. I don't think I get BD Boys. I don't feel that is the eyebrow-raising board game.
Cleaning up the streets one bad guy at a time. Nicely done, yeah. Sheriff.
But yeah, there's a lot of like that kind of stuff in Division.
Another one down. Good job, Agent.
But yeah, I think that will actually another World in Conflict.
Cleaning up the streets one bad guy at a time. Nicely done, Sheriff.
But yeah, this is how you get out here. But yeah, I think I very much will use this as an intro or outro position.
Looks like you earned yourself another bounty. Well done.
Maybe like facing that way for the intro and then facing that way for the outro. Because yeah, it is a cool looking visual. And also, a lot of people, like, I remember seeing this on a Reddit post and coming up here. Like, I didn't discover this myself. But yeah, it's kind of cool. Anyways, in this
hostiles are opening a supply drop.
Bad boys.
Hostiles detected.
Could be. I don't think. Well, I don't. I'm trying to think of what. Because yeah, most of them are like Ubisoft joints, but I don't think Bad Boys is. But yeah, I will take us to Washington, D.C. and White House. If you guys want to travel along, because yeah, that's usually where I leave my characters after runs, as I clean them up. As I said, D.C. is usually where we spend most of our days. When we are not starting up trouble in the neighborhood. Because I'm gonna clean up this character, and that will likely be it for me for this evening. And but I'll be back at it tomorrow evening. Likely I will set up kind of depends how my day tomorrow goes, as it might get a little bit busy. Hopefully it won't. I'll share this setup in a second, if I remember. But yeah, if it doesn't get super busy, I will actually set up a build showcase. And I think I will do it on this gal's... this turret headshot hybrid. Because yeah, I kind of like it. I think it would be a good build as a showcase build. Because yeah, it's weird, it's wacky, it works. That's kind of what I sometimes want out of a build showcase. To not always have them be just meta stuff or purpose-built setups, which is sometimes have a little bit of oddity in there. I'm gonna pop my 19 caches. Oh, we have to spend our stars. Yes, yeah, don't forget to spend your stars, people. If you haven't spent your stars, go and spend them before the event ends, because yeah, you don't get to spend them otherwise.
Nice doing business with you.
I almost did there. Oh, actually, I will. I will actually pick up that Fenris glove in a second. Is it shareable? So, sadly, it's not shareable anymore. Yes, that can become a... That can become a... I was for a second there considering keeping this piece, and I might actually consider keeping that piece. Just in case I find a knee pad, or, well, I'm going to craft them anyway. But then I can use that piece to... Although, yeah, actually what I likely will do, and this is just my silliness, is I'll likely make the glove Empress, just so that these three pieces are Empress, and then this is Worker, and then these two will be Habsburg, which will visually be pleasing to me. Although, actually, I can kind of see why I went with this holster, because, yeah, it's just one recalibration. But, yeah, that's no longer going to be the case anyway, so I will likely move the Empress to be up here and then craft Habsburg pieces for these two pieces. Just because, yeah, that will visually be a little bit better looking. So, yeah, I won't hang on to that one. Which is just going to cost me a bunch of resources. It's not going to be anything anything worthwhile. But yeah, we'll hang on to this those gloves, because those can become blue core ones, which are quite useful sometimes. Although actually they are shareable. I don't know if either of you needs a Fenris glove. Because otherwise, say so. Because for me, they're likely just going to be a visual upgrade. Because I still also have this ones in my stash. But yeah, I would be willing to share them if somebody needs them. But yeah, feel free to say so. But yeah, for the rest of it, I'm going to do my outro here. We're going to... I will set up this. I will actually make... a little bit of a spreadsheet for it, but not so much about its damage numbers, because its damage numbers don't really matter. This isn't a DPS, well, not in that way, not in a DPS sense. But I will likely capture numbers for it, basically what it does on the Nemesis with the first shot, and then like with the second shot and the third shot, just kind of, and also with the scalpel, what it does on the... Because yeah, I do have like the full shots with Headhunter on the build picture, but especially, yeah, kind of like what shot can you expect on the first shot with the Nemesis and stuff. And likely I will run it and use it in some ways with a build showcase. Although likely for most of it, I will do it mostly solo, because this build is very much a solo-oriented build. Although maybe I'll do a CP and stuff with a group, and maybe I'll grab some regulars from here. Although, yeah, that will basically mostly be to show that it doesn't really work in groups. It will be basically one CP to like show that, like, when you're competing with people and stuff, it becomes a lot much more of a hassle than it's worth. And at that point, you might as well just swap to something else. Although this whole build is more hassle than it's worth. But sometimes the hassle is half the fun. Hassling okay, I'm saying that they're good. But yeah, sometimes hassle is the game, basically. Just playing the mechanic of this thing is kind of enjoyable. And yeah, I have the option of running it with tech support or with vigilance. So I'll likely tomorrow spend some time recalibrating this to vigilance, seeing if it feels any better. Likely it won't, because I have played with this build quite a bit, especially in the past, like in the long past. Because yeah, this is actually a very old build. And I remember running it with vigilance and coming to a conclusion of like liking tech support a little bit better. Although now thinking about it, why wouldn't I put combined arms here? It becomes the question. Which, yeah, is an option as well. But yeah, I'll mess about with those stuffs and we'll go into a build showcase tomorrow. And I'll likely have some decision made. Oh, yeah. As I just said it, I almost forget it. I'm going to buy a lot of these exotic caches. How far am I from a level? I'm too far. Too far to care. Let's pop some of these exotic caches. As I don't think I have any exotic in mind for keeping, I feel. But yeah, unless there's a guard roll version, it might be a replacement for on one of the characters.
Thanks for the deal.
I should have checked in here, but I think we got 16 exotic caches out of it.
Good to see you.
Which is a decent haul for a global event. I didn't farm too hard, but I did spend some time playing a lot. That will go into our pool, and actually I can make it out from here as well, because yeah, we have now 74. So if this takes us to 90, then it was 16. And it takes us to 90, which will be kept around for the new season, mostly. Unless I really get a bunch. maybe with Golden Bullet, but I'll likely still keep like more than 100 around, just to go to Expertise 24, get a Ouroboros to 20, re-roll some Ouroboroses as well, re-roll some Iron Lungs as well. So yeah, it's worth hanging on to these and not spending them nowadays till the new season. But yeah, that was an important thing to do. Yeah, do spend your stars, don't forget to do so. But yeah, that's going to be it for me, as I'm going to thank Pomek and Salty for running most of the evening for me. I don't remember if anybody else was there, but if they were, thanks to them as well. Although, yeah, I think it was the three of us for most of the evening. But yeah, I'll be back at it tomorrow evening, same time. And also, yeah, tomorrow, of course, Golden Bullet starts, which will be fun for a day or two, so we'll be good. And yeah, thanks everybody for watching, and thanks also to those that watch the VODs and get to these points. And I'll let Pomek do his outro, and then, and then I will follow him up with my own, as he will speed off, and then I will do my spiel, as indeed Pomek the Hedgehog speeding off, and followed up by me wishing you all to have a good night.